Tonight, two new kickboxing world champions will be crowned. Legendary Muay Thai world champion Sam A. Gaiyanghadao takes on Chinese kickboxing world champion Wang Junguang for the inaugural One Strawweight Kickboxing World Championship. And Chinese knockout artist Zhang Chenlong battles with Russian powerhouse Alaverdi Ramazanov to become the first ever One Bantamweight Kickboxing World Champion. The greatest strikers on the planet face off, and history will be made. One Mark of Greatness from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia starts now. You're watching the best of One Championship. One Championship ended the year with a bang, as One Mark of Greatness in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia featured two historic world title bouts. Let's take a look at the event's exciting martial arts action. In the main event, former One Flyweight Muay Thai world champion Sam A. Gaiyanghadao made history for the second time in the promotion, as he faced off against Chinese kickboxing world champion Wang Junguang for the inaugural One Strawweight Kickboxing World Championship. Let's join this world title bout in the fifth and final round.
Can he become his country's first ever One Super Series world champion?
But have we ever had an athlete win in One Super Series, win a Muay Thai world title and a kickboxing world title? Is that history?
5th and final round, big left hand to overarm there for Wang Junguang.
Sorry, Stamp.
Can he turn on the power salvos for three more minutes? Will it be the slick counters of Sam A. Gaiyanghadao? There's the left hook. It's been the money shot for Wang Junguang. Sam A goes downstairs. Wang goes there too. Leads with the right hand, bangs the body, goes the head. Sam A backs him off with a round kick. Again, Wang on the inside, constantly coming forward, applying that pressure. Checks the low kick, nicely done. Inside the phone booth once more. No grappling allowed, they break. Sam A not coming forward. Intent to play it on the back foot. The counter strike. Use his speed, use that experience again. Picks him off that left once more there from Sam A. Trigger happy with the left hand, and it's fast. Wang Junguang trying to pin him against the wall. Eats a right hand of Sam A, just not enough pepper on it. Referee, oh, now he breaks them.
Sam A's finding a home for that left hand, and it's on the chin of Wang Junguang. Junguang's trying to push forward, trying to mix up the weapons, throwing that spinning back fist, moving forward. But Sam A just has a bit of a read on exactly what Wang Junguang's going to do. I like the inside leg kick that Wang Junguang's starting to throw. Touch up the leg, start throwing those headshots.
These two superb world champions. Two nice incredible right athletes. And now only 70 seconds away from one of them being crowned the Strawweight Kickboxing King. Body shot there from Wang Junguang, then goes to the jaw of Sam A. The chin's high! He backs up Sam A! Sam A takes a knee, locks up the arms, referee, oh, now he breaks them. Sam was carrying his chin high, and Wang Junguang made him pay. Hooks again, catches him with the right hand. Sam A. Gaiyanghadao looks tired now, breathing out of his mouth. He looks fatigued, he looks deflated. And Wang Junguang still pressing the action, still coming forward. Hooking punch, Sam A gets out of dodge. Roundhouse kick. Wang Junguang spins around, Sam A just closes him down. 20 seconds now. Are we gonna see China's first ever One Super Series world champion? Left hand connects. Wang Junguang continually applying the pressure. backing up Sam A. Final 10 seconds now. Wang Junguang has hardly taken a backward step. Sam A's countered beautifully. How will the judges see it?
Wow, you can start to see Wang Junguang was having success in that fifth round when he was starting to put those combinations together. Always pushing forward, trying to land those big headshots, and he was able to score. Was it the fatigue of Sam A, or was it just that constant pressure that was starting to break Sam A? But we got to see a lot of flurries coming from Wang Junguang. But you could see that Sam A was always moving, didn't eat any big clean shots except that one right there to end the combination. But Wang Junguang had a better round that time. But it's gonna come down to the judges' scorecards. Now it's time to do a little bit of math, figure out who is the one Super Series kickboxing strawweight world champ.
How do you score it, folks, wherever you're watching around the world? What an epic main event to cap off an epic year in one championship here in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Do you have it for that man, Sam A. Gaiyanghadao? Such a great contest that no one has left this arena during it. Sold out, and they're all still here, eagerly anticipating this decision. Let's find out our winner. Let's go to Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And now, the one Super Series strawweight kickboxing world champion from the red corner, Sammy
Two-sport world champion in one Super Series. He's got another reign of gold. Another Thai world champion.
In the co-main event of the night, another historic moment as Aliberti Ramazanov and Zhang Chenlong faced off to claim the inaugural ONE Bantamweight Kickboxing World Championship. Let's join this action-packed world championship contest in the fifth and final round.
For the ONE Super Series Bantamweight Kickboxing World Championship in beautiful Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. We saw a knockdown in the third round. Ramazanov planted Zhang Chenlong with a beautiful right hand. Three judges scoring a 10-point must system here. And there's a moment of honor between two true martial artists.
Nice little show of respect right there from Aliberti Ramazanov as he wanted a hug, but it also shaved about 8 seconds off the clock, too. Nice little counter. Aliberti, he needs to turn it on. As you can see, Zhang Chenlong is starting to go at it, landing big shots. Trying to close that distance, realizing he needs a knockout here. He might want to start working the body and then go up top.
Aliberti, oh, connects beautifully again. The jab too is superb of Aliberti Ramazanov. Step through knee, Zhang Chenlong with the counter. Ramazanov going down that center corridor now, going down that straight line. And look at Zhang, all over him, trying to back up the Dagestani, rips to the body. Good jab. Knee to the jaw from Zhang Chenlong. Just grazed the whiskers of Ramazanov. Ramazanov backs him off with a left.
This is what Zhang Chenlong predicted. He predicted that Ramazanov would fade in the fourth and fifth round, and he was able to find his opportunities. But because of the knockdown in the third, the scoring might be lopsided. Zhang Chenlong's got to keep going, looking for that monstrous left hand.
A very busy, a very active scoring round for Zhang Chenlong so far. But now, he's also got an 8-10 round against him in the third. How will that play out on the scorecards? Can he drop Ramazanov?
Well, you can see him starting to go to the body. And you can see Ramazanov's carrying that left hand a little bit lower to protect that side of his body. Sorry, the right hand, as Zhang Chenlong starts to unload on him. Good movement from Ramazanov.
Front kick, roundhouse kick there from Ramazanov. Clinches up again. Trying to shave a few seconds, grind down the clock a little, Alverdi Ramazanov, breathing through his mouth. Uppercut went wild. Here comes Wang Junguang applying the pressure.
Again, keeps coming forward, but Ramazanov is able to counter-strike. He's able to land these shots. Little tie up there. Nice little step in.
Junguang's going for it. He wants to knock down Ramazanov, get a 10-8 round himself. They're both going for it now. Ramazanov turned his back. Well, Ramazanov turned his back. You can't do that. Junguang comes forward on him again. Ramazanov could be in trouble. Junguang continues to pour it on. But can he drop him? 15 seconds remaining. What a round for Junguang. Tenacious. All over it. Continually coming forward. But Ramazanov still here. Ramazanov still dancing. And we are going down to the judges. Who will become the bantamweight world champion?
Wow, that was, man, the fourth and fifth. You might have to give the nod to Junguang, but the first three, especially with the knockdown in the third, it might come down to the first, how the judges saw it in the very first round. Ramazanov was teeing off in the first three, but then the fourth and the fifth, exactly what Junguang said was gonna happen, that Ramazanov would tire and he would be able to take advantage of it. But it was that monstrous right hand from Ramazanov in the third round that did the damage, that dropped, that sat him down. Ramazanov did a good job of striking off that back foot to, you know, compensate for that pressure coming from Junguang. But Junguang never let up. Good at back and forth action. What a tremendous matchup.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And now, the one Super Series Bantamweight Kickboxing World Champion from the red corner, Alverdi Ramazanov.
The knockdown in the third round made all the difference. Alverdi Ramazanov is the world champion. The 25-year-old has the bantamweight strap to take back to Russia.
Filipino Denise Zamboanga came to impress in her one championship debut. And she did just that as she faced a tough challenge in home country hero, Jihin Radzwan.
Denise Zamboanga!
Coming up after the break, Malaysian hero, Aguilan Tani. You're watching the Best of One Championship. Welcome back to the Best of One Championship. Malaysian hero Aguilan Tani got back to winning ways in front of his home crowd as he went up against the undefeated American, Dante Skiro, in Skiro's promotional debut. We join the action in round three.
What a match we've got here. Jab there from Dante Skiro on debut here at Guam. Tani threads the hands, goes a leg kick, no starch behind it. Skiro turns him with a left hook. Tani on the inside, overhand right.
Tani's doing a good job of taking the initial control of the exchange. Now he's got that double body lock. Let's see if he can do anything with it as he has those double underhooks. You can see Skiro, he's not really trying to swim in. Now he pummels underneath, gets one underhook. Now we're in a neutral position. But Tani's got that leg locked. He likes that leg lace. And he likes to go for the outside reap.
Skiro eats an uppercut. And Tani breaks off. Uppercut elbow there from Dante Skiro. They drift to center circle. Wild right hand from the American. Tani backs off, resets, comes forward, throws a roundhouse kick to the lower right rib cage. Jab two there from Tania. Jumping knee from Skiro, tried to tuck it under the chin. A left hook! Another left hook! He shaves the beard of Skiro with that one. And Tania dances. Skiro, a lazy attempt at a takedown. Backs him against the circle wall now.
Good defense from Aguilan Tani as he mixes in the striking attacks. Gets the body lock. This is usually a good sign if he can get his hands clasped. He's usually going to take somebody for a ride, but Skiro is a very highly tuned wrestler, so he should be able to defend it. Let's see if he can pummel in. Good hand control from Tani on that left side.
Aguilan Tani, the 24-year-old out of Kuala Lumpur, born in Penang. And he finished the night, finished the year with a victory for himself and these Malaysian fans. Big crossing elbow from Tani to the temple. Tani edges forward, 250 remains, third and final round kick there from the Malaysian.
Tani's really improved his kicks, and that could be the difference in the stand-up here, is just Tani being able to show a little bit more weapons. Goes inside, goes to the body again. Nice catch. He's able to do a lot with this, but he's able to enter into the body lock. Has the hands below the hips. Let's see if he can take Skiro for the ride. Good job by Dante Skiro to keep it standing.
2 minutes, 20 remains. Three judges scoring on an overall contest, not round by round. Wherever you're watching around the world, folks, in over 140 countries, how are you scoring it so far? Don't forget to follow us across all your social media platforms, YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, at One Championship.
This is definitely a battle. It's going to come down to these last 2 minutes. I think Tani has been able to build up a little bit of a lead, but not by much. Good hand exchanges, good counter striking by Dante Skiro as he lands a nice little uppercut there.
Right hand from Skiro.
Oh, open up, Tani.
Tani outside leg kick. Skiro having some success with his hands here in the third round. Eats the uppercut to Tani, misses with a left hook. There's a good straight right hand from Skiro.
Looks like Skiro's been able to figure out the timing and the range on Tani. He's been able to do a little bit of handiwork here with the boxing.
On the One Fantasy game on the One Super app, 67% of fans tipping a win for Aguilan Tani. Tani flicks around, kick to the lower right ribcage, uppercut. Tries to put the chin through the top of the head. Comes forward the Malaysian, 1 minute to go now, some would say 60 seconds. Spinning heel kick there from Dante Skiro. Right hand from Tani, looks to back up the American. Follows him to the center of the circle, and now Skiro backs up.
Good job by Tani to control that center circle, but Dante is doing a good job of counter striking. Putting his hands together. He needs something big here in the last 30 seconds.
Overhand left from Tani. A cut about his left eye. Skiro tries for a left hook, a wild uppercut. There goes Tani! Find out that right hand. Tani in the phone booth now. Keeps coming forward, the alligator. Listen to this crowd. They're bringing him home. We're going down to the judges in Kuala Lumpur. Will it be a Malaysian victory for Aguilan Tani?
Wow, we got to see a lot of back and forth action. There was a beautiful step in flying knee there from Dante Skiro as Tani was able to land a few shots on the exit. Man, just a total back and forth battle. But I think the difference maker could have been that early ground control coming from Aguilan Tani.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this contest in favor of the red corner. Judge number two calls this contest in favor of the blue corner. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision from the red corner.
For that man, Aguilan Thani, a win for the alligator, a win for Malaysia.
In an exciting matchup for martial arts fans around the world, Australia's Reece McLaren went up against India's top mixed martial artist, Gurdarshan Mangat.
Cracks down onto the orbital, measures it, takes the back. Oh, trouble! Big trouble! Huge trouble!
Oh, the chin,
yes,
looking.
Trouble.
Oh, it slid
it's
right
over.
Underneath.
It's over. It's over. Reece McLaren back in the winner's circle.
In a light heavyweight kickboxing showdown, Super Combat Super Cruiserweight World Champion Andre Stoica put on a tremendous performance against Brazilian National Kickboxing Champion Anderson Silva.
Left hook from Stoica, a beauty. He tagged it. He shaved the beard. He tagged it. The big kibosh! Silver's hurt! Silver and rubber legs! Oh, this is over! It's good night, Irene! It's good night, Irene! Andre Stoica sends a message!
Undefeated South African Vokang Masanyane excited the Malaysian crowd in his one championship debut against Japan's Ryuto Sawada.
Vokang Masanyane!
After the break, more martial arts action from Kuala Lumpur. You're watching the Best of One Championship. Welcome back to the Best of One Championship. Multiple-time Muay Thai world champions went toe-to-toe as Elias Mahmoudi faced Lurdsila Phuket Top Team in a flyweight Muay Thai bout.
Elias Mahmoudi!
China's Chen Rui upset the crowd as he earned a unanimous decision victory over Malaysian star Muhammad Aiman.
Chen Rui!
Tiao Tang took the center of the circle from the first minute as he put pressure on Kim Yoon Kwon for the duration of their bantamweight matchup. A huge late takedown and elbows from the guard put him in the driving seat after the first round, and he continued to put his stamp on the contest in the second as he set a high pace. Though Kim was active with his right kick to the head and body, the Myanmar hero landed the harder, cleaner strikes. The South Korean was almost knocked down when he buckled from the power of a low kick and left hook. And then Tiao Tang continued to damage him with boxing combinations. Tiao Tang continued his dominance in the final round. He continued to march forward with punches in bunches, scored with knees in the clinch, and controlled the action on the mat after he planted Kim with a huge slam to earn a unanimous decision win. South Korean Yoon Chang-min showcased his skill set with the second-round submission of Filipino Rodian Menchavez.
Jumping knee, channeling his inner Martin Nguyen there.
Uh-oh, guillotine. Oh, looks like he's going Dars.
This could be the big hit here. It's over.
He's tapping on the other side.
Yoon is a beast. What a monster this man is.
Shootboxing super bantamweight champion Takei Naito earned the unanimous decision over European kickboxing champion Rui Botello. Brazil's Rayan Bastos caught a first-round submission of Cambodian-American Savannah M.
Bastos got that guillotine nice and tight. She falls to the head. Looks like a DDT right there. Savannah Riem looks like that was a...
That's a tap.
Possible tap.
How about that for Rayan Bastos? First-round submission win.
Thank you for watching the Best of One Championship.